everyone! So today I'm going to show you how to make this cute black cat that's perfect for Halloween. So to begin, you will need your rainbow loom in the offset configuration with the arrows pointing towards you, a hook, some black bands, some white bands, and some pink bands. So to get started, we are going to make the arms and legs of our cat first. And to do that, you want to take one single pink band, you want to twist it around two times, so you could see three rings right there, and take two black bands, stretch it out, and bring those pink bands inside those black bands. I want to take another two black bands, stretch it out, and bring those in. Now you want to set this aside, and I'm going to show you how to make it one more time. So that's twist it around twice, so that's one. You should see three rings right there. Take two black bands, stretch it, bring the pink bands in, put the black bands inside a hook, and then take another two black bands, stretch it out, bring it in, and there you go. So set that aside, and you should make a total of four of these. So I've made two ahead of time, so I have a total of four. And then I'm going to make the cat's ears, and to do that you want to take one single black band, twist it around twice, so that's one and two, that's three rings right there. Take two black bands, stretch it, and bring the black bands in. So that's, we need to do that three more times. You already have one. So it's two. Three and four. Now you need to make two of these. So I already made one ahead of time, so I have two. You want to set that aside. Now for your cat's eyes, I have perler beads with me that I cut in half, and I'm going to use that for my cat's eyes. But if you don't have one, you can simply do the cat's eyes by twisting one white band twice, taking a black band, twist it once, and bring it in. So that is basically one of the eye. I'm just going to show you how to make the other eye. So twist it around twice. One, two, three rings right there. Twist the black band once. You will see two rings right there. Stretch it out. So you have the eyes on your hook. All you need to do now is grab one single black band and bring those in like so. Oopsie. Uh-oh. like so. And all you need to do is place them right here. Once I'm going to show you later on how to place the eyes, but that is basically how you do the eyes on your rainbow loom. Now if you have perler beads like me, you want to take one single black band, a floss, and you want to wrap it around the black band. Just insert one single band inside. Bring the two floss together. And then I have a white perler bead that I cut in half like this. And you just want to insert both beads inside the floss and pull them till you reach the middle of your single black band. Now to make the nose, if you don't have a perler bead, you can always use your rainbow loom. And to do that, you want to take one single pink band, twist it around twice. You have the C3 rings right there. You take one single black band, stretch it out, and bring it in like so. So you want to set that aside, and we're going to begin assembling or creating the face and the body of our cat. So you want to take two bands and you start from the top diagonally. Take another two, bring it down vertically. Another two. Another two bands diagonally. And you want to do the same thing on the other side. So you take two bands diagonally. And then another two bands vertically. Two bands vertically. Two bands diagonally. So you should have a shape that looks like this, and then you want to put two bands in the middle. Just vertical bands in the middle, like so. Now I'm going to move my loom a bit further down. I'm going to place two bands vertically once more, and that's going to be the cat's neck. And then two bands diagonally. Another two bands diagonally on the other side, and that will be the cat's shoulder. So two bands, put them horizontally. You want to do that two more times, so you should have a total of three vertical double bands. And you want to do the same thing on the other side. And you want to place bands in the middle, starting from the shoulder part, right there. Another two bands. And another two. So you should have a total of three as well, vertical bands using double black bands. And now I'm going to attach the eyes, ears, arms and legs of our cat. So I want to start off with the head, and take one of the ears that we made earlier. Now you want to put your hook inside this loose end right there. And you want to place it on the bottom right or the third peg down on the right side. Place all those bands inside. Twist it to the side. Now you have your capping band right here. This is where your capping band is. The next band to the capping band is where you want to insert your hook. So let me just change the angle of my loom. So you want to stretch it out. Insert it to the next bands after a capping band. Insert it in the middle. Take one single black band and you want to pull that through inside. Bring the single black band together on your hook and you want to attach this single bands or single band to the first peg on the right. Should have something that looks like this, and we're going to do that on the other side as well. So take one of the ears, insert your hook where the loose ends are, you should have a total of 4 bands on your hook. And then on the third peg on the left is where you want to attach the loose ends. Like so. Now again, you want to stretch your band. This is your capping band, the very tip. And then the next band after the capping band, you want to insert your hook inside. Take one single black band and pull it through. Bring the single black band together and you're going to attach that to the first peg on your left. I want to give it a stretch, a little stretch. And then for the eyes, I am going to be using my perler beads. So I have this ready. So you want to attach it to the second peg right here, right across the second peg on the other side, and part them in the middle. Bring both eyes to the side. Now taking this upper part of the band, you want to insert it on the second peg in the middle. Now for the nose, you want to attach that to the third peg right here and on this side. And just put it in the middle. And there you go. So now you want to attach your arms and legs. So you take one of these that we made earlier. Make sure you have 4 bands on your hook. And you want to attach it on this peg where the shoulders are. And you want to do the same thing on the other side. So now for the legs, you want to take the leg part, make sure you have 4 bands there, and you're going to attach it at the bottom. take the other leg, attach it on the other side, and put it, twist it to the side. Like so. And now we're going to put some black bands to hold them together. So you take one single black band, place it on the peg below where the arms are, like so, in order for you to make a triangle. Do that again. And then another one at the bottom. Now, the bottom of the triangle right here, you want to bring that up to the middle peg. And now we are ready to loop our black cat. So I'm just going to start off on the left side first, go inside the channel, grab the two bottom black bands, and just want to bring it up. Now start looping your bands up. Like so. Now on to the other side, grab the two bottom black bands and just keep on looping up like so. Want to push that down a little so it doesn't pop off from your loom. And now on the middle part, you want to just grab these two bands and just bring them up. And just loop them like single chains going up, like so. Now you have two diagonal bands right here, so you want to go inside the channel. Go inside the channel, grab two bands, two bottom bands, and bring it to the middle. I'm gonna push it down a little. So do the same thing on the other side, grabbing the two bottom bands, bringing it to the center or the middle. Now you have to be careful on this part where the shoulder, head, and neck meets, because there's lots of bands on this part of your loom, and there's quite a lot of tension for the bottom bands if you pull them to bring them back to this peg. So you want to do that carefully so you don't snap your bands. So go inside your channel, grab the two black bands, and I'm just going to wiggle this carefully and bring it up so I don't snap any bands. Moving on to our cat's face, you want to grab the two top bands. And you want to bring it up, that goes in the center, and just loop your way up, and then go back down to where the neck part is, grab the two top bands, bring it to the right, grab the two bottom bands, bring it up. Another two bottom bands, bring it up. So go back down here, grab the last two bands, bring it to the left. Go inside your channel again, grab the two bottom bands, bring it up. Just bring it up. Now you will see two diagonal bands on both sides, and just want to go inside the first peg, grab the two bottom bands, bring it to the center, do the same thing on the other side, and bring it to the center. I'm going to push this down a little so it doesn't pop off from my loom. And now we are ready to take the black cat off our loom. So I'm going to hold down this part right here where the loose ends are, and I'm going to carefully try to take it off the loom. Now this is where the loose end is. So you want to stick your loom inside the channel. There's going to be lots of bands on that area. Stick your loom. Grab one single band and I want to pull it through. Like so. Hold it securely. Take it off the loom. You want to seal off the loose ends by bringing this band inside the band that's on the right. Always give it a tug. And this is what it should look like. So you want to give it a little stretch. And add whiskers like I did. Over here, you want to take two single white bands and then grab your black cat and take the band that's beside the nose area. Grab those two bands. Take your white band, single white band, pull it through. Like so, and then bring this white, the left side inside on the right side. You want to do the same thing on the other side. So grab the two black bands that's right beside the nose. Take one single white band, pull it through. And make a slip knot by bringing this band on the left to the right side and just go through inside. It doesn't look like a whiskers yet. You can just take your scissors and cut through here, but since I don't have one with me, I'm just going to use my X-Acto knife. I'm just going to place it down, cut it, do the same thing on the other side. And cut it. And that's gonna make your cat's whiskers.